So today we are beginning with the unit 5 for your electric drives and traction subject. So the title of the unit 5 is electric traction. So as I have already described in the last video, electric traction is a study of electrical trains. Mainly we are studying about the trains working all over the world and majorly on India. So electrical trains, what are their advantages over other trains systems? That is for the beginning, steam diesel engine systems, steam engine systems, and for the urban, semi-urban, or for the mainline system. Mainline system, that means for systems which are working on a longer distance, will be called as mainline systems. We will be studying about all those components in this chapter. So to begin the study of this electrical traction system, the major components what we should know is a speed time curve. That is what the component, key component for the traction system. So speed time curve represents the study of train or a study of electrical traction in various modes, that means various intervals. For example, as we all know that the train will begin from one station and it will end up in the another station. So through this journey between the two stations, when it starts, the train will begin to accelerate. So it will begin to accelerate after certain interval, it will reach to some level of speed, and it will maintain that speed for certain duration, and once the another station arrives, it will start decreasing the speed. That is, from the station 1 to station 2, it has the level of changes, that is called as acceleration, then continuous speed, and then we have retardation. So based on this, the if I draw this different intervals of the curve, traction system on the speed versus time curve, while having speed on the y axis and time on the x axis, it is known as speed time curve. And the analysis of this speed time curve by taking the area covered by this curve will be giving us the proper consideration of what is the requirement of having rising time, what is the requirement of having proper distancing, and between the two constant speeds, and what is the requirement of braking of the train. So main thing what differs between the traction system and the normal vehicle running on the roads will be, in case of traction system, there is no changes in these curves as compared to normal main road systems wherein the vehicles are running, like car, trucks and all. So what is the reason? That is because the traction system do not have any interruptions. For example, in case of roads, there may be damage of roads, there may be disturbances in the roads, so we may have to increase or decrease the speed at any interval. So therefore, it is very difficult to obtain the speed time curve for the normal road system when the vehicle is moving from one destination to another destination. But in case of electrical traction or in case of traction system, railway systems, it is not so, because railways do not have any interruptions in between. Once they begin from one destination and reaches to another destination, there are all the components are described. That is what we know. The trains, we know their timings. We know their timings are fixed at the given station at a given time, and it is predefined. So that means we are defining the timings, and it is well known. And nowadays, because of the advancement in the systems, digitization systems, we will be also knowing what will be the time of reach for the trains based on some advanced techniques. So of course, we don't have that in our studies, but we should know that. So that is the advantage. Now, what will be the major advantage of electrical traction system will be, the first thing is it is a pollution free. The component of electrical traction traction system over the steam as well as diesel engine is pollution free. Second thing, over the diesel, it is a consumption free, pollution free. Over the steam, it is fast running, or it is a quick action traction system as compared to steam engines, wherein in case of steam engines, we have to get the steam engine started by burning the coal or whatsoever it is generating the steam, it is a longer length process or time consuming. So it is a fast system. Second thing is, in case of diesel and coal system, when the retardation applied, retardation in the sense braking system has been applied, there will be loss of consumptions whatever done, that is for example fuel, or loss of energy generated, very much loss will be there as compared to that of electrical system, wherein the braking will be very convenient as compared to that of remaining two systems. Okay, so these are the major components of studies for having advantages of electrical traction system over any other system. Okay, so by knowing this, we will be studying about the electrical traction system mainly on the speed time curve. What are the different speed time curves in the different locations, for example urban traction system or mainline traction system, and then we are studying about how the different curves will be producing their respective analysis, and based on that we also have the numericals, and we will be knowing different parameters of the electrical traction systems. We have their definitions as well. So before we begin, we should first component we should study is about speed time curve of the traction system. So speed time curve. So what is a speed time curve? It is the curve between the speed and time by having speed produced on the y axis, which has been represented either in kilometer per hour or kilometer per second, and then majorly it is displayed in terms of kilometer per hour, and having y axis as a time represented either in minute or in seconds. So the curve drawn between the speed as well as time by having speed on the x y axis and time on the x axis, representing speed in case of kilometer per hour, speed in terms of kilometer per hour, and time in terms of seconds or minutes, the curve produced will be known as speed time curve for the electrical traction system. So this speed time curve has different intervals with respect to different conditions of the traction, that is acceleration, smooth moving or free running it is called as, and then retardation. So based on that, the different intervals will be produced on the speed time curve. So let me just produce the speed time curve. I will represent the time intervals as T1, T2, T3, and let us take it as T4 with respect to speed here. And then in the acceleration part, I have mentioned the two different intervals. First interval is a rheostatic acceleration. I will just explain how they are different and why they are different. And then I have speed curve running. This is known as speed curve running. And then this is free run, or free running we can call it, and this is a retardation. These are the different intervals defined over the speed time curve. And before retardation, the retardation curve is also broken up into two intervals. I will just mention that. In the later part, we will just have the, so this is my braking. We have the definition for these two intervals, braking and next one as coasting. Okay, So these are some of the intervals. Now for that, I have two more different identity zeros of time. This is T4 and this is T5. Okay. Now let us study what all these definitions or what all these components are. Now just take it here. Let us assume that this is my position 1 and this is my position 2, wherein, or destination 1 and destination 2, wherein the train has to move at having some level of speed. That is a maximum speed, we can call it. Now when it is running, let us consider that at destination 1, initially the train is in, or traction system is in off state. So what I have to do? We are entirely studying about the electrical traction. So all the components with respect to electrical component we will be knowing. So initially when the train is in off state, I have to turn it on and it has to get accelerated. Now we know that the basic formula V is equal to I into R. So in the initial state, what I am doing is, I am just maintaining the current constant. That means the current of the drive traction system, I will be keeping it as constant. And that means to increase the voltage, I have to increase the voltage to get it accelerate. Okay? So to increase the voltage, I have to increase the resistance values. So as I increase the resistance, ultimately the V component, voltage component will be rising. And that's why it is named as acceleration of the drive, and which is even possible because of resistance. So it is known as rheostatic acceleration. So initially it will accelerate. So it will accelerate till the interval of T1. At interval T1, now the speed is already picked up the speed or already in the motion. Now the amount of effort required to keep it rising the speed will be very less. So what I will be doing? Now after T1, I will be reducing this. So when I am reducing the voltage, I am increasing the current. Okay? So rheostat I will be reducing as well as current will be increasing. So the interval between T1 to T2, which is known as speed curve running, in this I am just reducing the voltage so that it will slowly rise the speed and it will reach its maximum value. At the interval T2, it will reach the speed which is prescribed as the maximum speed of the traction system. And from T1 till T2, the speed of the train will be continuously at the same level. That is known as free running. That is at maximum speed, it will run between the destination 1 to destination 2. That is between the time T1 and T3. Now let us consider at T3, what will happen is, the train is close to destination 2. Now it has to start decreasing. So initially what I will do? I will reduce the speed by cutting off the supply. So between the T3 and T4, what I will do is, I will cut off the supply for the drive. So when I cut off the supply, the speed will slowly start decreasing. And once it reduced to certain level, let us consider this. At this level, I will start applying the brakes. Okay? So from beginning to end, initially, it will rheostatic acceleration, wherein I am increasing the voltage. After picking up certain speed, I will just start reducing the voltage so that it will gradually increase slowly and it will reach to the maximum value of speed. Between T1 to T3, it will maintain that speed continuously. That is a free run. And at T3, the drive will be turned off. That means the speed will slowly start decreasing. And at interval T4, I will be applying the brake so that it will go to the off state. That means the drive will be in the zero speed at interval T5. So this is how the study of traction system will be carried out. For any traction system you consider, this speed time curve will be re-maintained. Now depending on which type of traction system it is, we have different class, that is urban and semi-urban, we can call it, and then main traction system, main line. So how they are different is, in case of urban traction system, the distance between the two stations or distance between the two locations will be very less. So therefore the amount of time required to pick the speed, amount of time required to break down the speed are very less as compared to the mainline system, and the duration between the stops is also less, therefore free running time will also be reduced. So as if there is nothing called as free running time in the urban line system, whereas in case of semi urban line system, the distance may be considered as it is between the range of 8 to 10 kilometers, so wherein we will get little bit time to rise up the speed and maintain it for certain duration, and then we are decreasing it. Okay, so it is advancement of urban, but we have the distance will be little bit more than that of urban system. And in case of mainline system, the curve is entirely suits with the spare time curve ideal characteristics. So based on this curve, it has all the components derived, because the distance between the curves between the two stations may be more than 20 kilometers, or sometimes it is 100, 200 kilometers, and so on, depending on the destinations between the stations. Okay. So I'll just quickly revise the definition components. Acceleration. So acceleration has two components, that is constant acceleration and speed curve running, that is acceleration on the speed curve. So what is constant acceleration? During the notching up period, that means during the period between 0 to T1, the current is maintained approximately constant, and the voltage across the motor is gradually increased. So this is voltage curve, and the amount of power is equal to V into I. So current is maintained constant and voltage is gradually increasing. So that means ultimately the power applied to the motor will be increasing. Okay. So gradually increased by cutting out the static starting rheostat. So we are cutting out this rheostat, therefore the voltage is increasing, and then since the voltage is increasing, the power applied to the drive will be increased. So the this is called as starting rheostat. So therefore it is also known as rheostatic acceleration. And in this case, the tractive efforts are constant, therefore it is acceleration remains constant during this period. And then speed curve running, second component, speed curve running, or it is also known as acceleration on speed curve. So during the speed curve running, that is between the interval T1 and T2, the voltage acting across the motor remains constant and the current starts decreasing. So between the interval this and this, what I am doing, I will be keeping voltage constant and I will be start decreasing the current. So ultimately the power whichever required to move from one to pick up the momentum will be very large as compared to power required here. So therefore, since it is in running state, so therefore I am reducing the current and I am keeping the voltage constant. So as current reduces, it will ultimately pick up a certain level of speed and it will maintain that speed. That is known as speed curve running. So once it reaches that, during this period, though the train accelerates, but the acceleration decreases with increase in speed. So even though it is accelerating, the acceleration decreases with increase in speed, because the current is decreasing. So we are slowly decreasing. Initially it is high, reducible, and once it reaches here, the current will be very less as compared to whatever applied at the initial stage. So then it reaches the maximum speed value. Then free run or constant speed run, at the end of interval T2, the speed curve running, that is T2, the train attains the maximum speed, and during this period the main speed, that is the train runs at constant speed for the certain interval known as constant power run, and it is for this interval the power consumed by the drive will remains constant. So the interval between for the free running will be between T2 to T3. Then next we have the coasting. At the end of the free running period, what we are doing, that is at T3, we are just cutting off the power supply and the train is allowed to run under its own momentum. So at this T3, I am just cutting off the power supply. So because of its momentum, the train is continuously allowed to move at its own speed and it starts decreasing. So till here it will decrease it down, And at T4, we are just starting applying the braking. So that is what retardation or braking period. At the end of coasting period, the braking are applied to bring the train to the rest part. So during this period, the speed decreases rapidly and finally reduces to zero value. So that is what some of the components of speed time curve. In the notes, I have given the definitions. You can go through that. So during the exam, even if they ask you to write a short note on speed time curve, you don't have to mention about that. It will be specifically mentioned. So speed time curve means you have to plot this speed time curve. You have to represent different intervals of the speed time curve, and you have to define individual interval. So what will be happening? What is the power? What is the voltage increase, decrease? What is mean by free run? Coasting means what? Those components you have to elaborate with their definition. So the typical speed time curves will be first one urban, and then we have semi-urban, or it is also known as suburban areas. We can just, or it is also known as suburban areas. Now depending on the distances, the different speed time curves will be there. Urban or city services, then semi-urban or suburban services, and then mainline service. So based on the distances, it will be varied. Now since in case of city or urban areas, since the distance between the two stops is comparatively very short, the time required for this run is very small. The acceleration as well as retardation is required to be high, and that average speed and high, so that the average speed and the short time of running is obtained. Okay, so there is no free running time for the urban curve. So urban curve will be of this nature. It will be reaching acceleration, then decreasing, and this one. If you check this, the time interval for braking and acceleration is very quick, very high, and it starts decreasing. At reaches here, it will be continuously starts moving down. Okay, so these are the some of the intervals for urban system. The suburban systems will also follow the same graph, but there will be certain free movement or free running time will be little bit more as compared to that of urban areas, and then it starts decreasing. So this will be my free running time. So acceleration time will be little bit more as compared to urban areas. And in case of mainline system, it follows all the components as shown in the speed time curve main distance. So depending on the acceleration times or acceleration in kilometers per hour and retardation times or retardation in kilometer per hour, then the maximum speed achieved and the distance between the stops, these categories are been made. So in case of urban system, the distance between the stations is 1 to 2 kilometer. In case of suburban, it is between 2 to 8 kilometer. In case of mainline, it is between more than 10 kilometer, any values, maximum values. In case of urban system, the acceleration will be in the range of 1.5 to 4 kilometer per hour per second. Suburban, it is in the range of 1.5 to 4, same. Then mainline, it is about 0.6 to 0.8 kilometer per hour per second. And retardation also, for urban and semi-urban, it is 3 to 4, and for mainline, it is 1.5. In case of urban and suburban, the maximum speed will be at the max 120, and in case of mainline, it may be up to 160, and nowadays it is increased up to 200 km per hour. Okay, so these are some of the parameters relevant to the speed time curve. Now for your next parameter, we have for the next component of your study, we have the study of speed time curve for urban and speed time curve for mainline system. So depending on their graphs or their nature, the speed time curves will be categorized into either as trapezoidal or quadrilateral speed time curve. So just check it here. Now whatever this nature of curve for the urban, suburban, and for the mainline system, we are just trying to convert them into some structure. So if I consider this, Just check it. It is following structure like this. If I consider this, it is following structure like this. Okay. So these are the structures for nature of studies for different components. Whereas in case of mainline system, it is following so just check it. It is following here in this case, it is following exact trapezoidal curve, and in case of this, it is a quadrilateral in nature. So that means it is increasing, little bit decreasing, and little bit down to the zero value. So we have the study of trapezoidal and quadrilateral, two different curves, and we are finding performing the analysis to find the different speed structures for them. So these are the nature of curves and different intervals. So T1, 0, T1, I have T2, T3 and so on. So I have the trapezoidal curve and quadrilateral curve. So the analysis are carried out for the urban and suburban using the quadrilateral curve, and for mainline system it is using the trapezoidal curve. So this analysis will be carried out by considering total time between 0 to T3, if you check it there in both the graphs, as T. By considering total time of run will be equal to T for both the curves. Okay. So let us perform the analysis individually for the conditions as a trapezoidal or quadrilateral. So trapezoidal, just remember that it may be during the exam, they may ask you to derive the expressions for the trapezoidal curve, or sometimes they may ask you derive the expression for the mainline service or mainline system, and they may ask you for urban line or suburban line systems. So you have to analyze based on whether it is trapezoidal or quadrilateral system. Okay. So let us perform first for the trapezoidal curve. So this analysis are carried out to determine what is the maximum speed achieved. Okay. So maximum speed. So before we go for this, some of the components we have to define. What are those? Are first one is crest speed. Next one is average speed. CREST. Crest speed, average speed, and scheduled speed. Or scheduled speed, or it is known as scheduled time as well. So these are some of the definitions which are important components for the next two derivations. Crest speed will be the maximum speed achieved by the given system, traction system, in a given speed time curve. So in case of trapezoidal and quadrilateral, this will be my maximum speed. So it is represented as Vm. In case of quadrilateral, this is the maximum speed, not this one. So this is known as Vm1, and I have one more, so I will mention that as Vm2. So two crest speeds we can have. So it is the maximum speed achieved by the traction system in a given intervals. Average speed. So average speed will be the average of all the three intervals, that is acceleration interval, pre-run interval, and the retardation interval. So crest speed is defined as the maximum speed attained by the vehicle during the run is known as crest speed. Average speed, the mean of the speed from the start to the stop, that is the distance covered between the two stops, divided by the actual time required, time of run, is known as average speed. So this is crest speed is Vm. Average speed, it is equal to the the distance covered, total distance covered divided by the total time required, that is t. Okay, so I can say that distance covered, if it is say s, it is s by t. Okay, and what is schedule speed? It is defined as the distance covered divided by the distance between the two stops plus the amount of time taken for the stopping at single destination. So that is known as stop time. So stop time plus the time of run, total time of run, will be considered as the total timeline for the scheduled speed. So scheduled speed considers the time of run as well as stop time at the destination. So the ratio of distance, so scheduled time, scheduled speed will be defined as the ratio of distance covered between the two stops and the total time of run including the time of stop, which is known as scheduled speed. So there are some of the factors which are affecting the scheduled speed. So those factors are scheduled speed, you already know that scheduled speed means the time at which certain destination to be reached by the traction system. So there are some factors which affect the scheduled speed. So those are acceleration and braking, the retardation. Next one, maximum or crest speed and duration of stop. So these are the factors which are affecting. So you can easily figure it out. So what are the first factor is acceleration or deceleration. For example, we know that the from destination 1 to destination 2, the train is running. At certain interval it is rising, then it is having free run, and then it is retarding. Suppose in worst case, there may be situations wherein the train has got some delays, or somewhere it has applied over speed, where it has applied the braking, or acceleration time may take more, retardation time may take more or less time. So based on that, the scheduled time will be different. So if I increase or decrease this, the total time will be increasing. So therefore, the scheduled time has collapsed. So first factor will be, you remember that first factor is based on time of run. So that is total time will be either increasing or decreasing. If acceleration increases very fast, then the time will be decreasing. If acceleration is very slow, time is decreasing. If braking is very fast, time is decreasing. If braking is very slow, time is increasing. Next factor is based on the maximum or crest speed. If suppose for a given drive between the two destinations, if Vm is the maximum speed, if I increase this Vm to Vm1 or decrease to Vm2, the amount of time required will be ultimately changes. That means either increasing or decreasing. In case of Vm1, that means increase of Vm more than Vm will be required less time, less than Vm requires more time to reach the destination. That is the another factor affecting the scheduled speed. And last one, duration of the stop. That means it is depends on time of stop. At a certain stop, if the vehicle has been if the traction system is retained for certain longer duration, that ultimately impacts the total run time. So scheduled time means, in spite of having a difference in the time of run, if stop time or time of stop increases or decreases, ultimately the scheduled time will be changing. Okay, so either based on run or time of run or time of stop, these are the factors which are affecting the speed of traction system or scheduled speed of the traction system. Okay, now let us perform the analysis for the maximum speed for the first curve, that is for mainline curve, using the trapezoidal speed time curve. So it is named as trapezoidal speed time curve. Or during the exam, they may ask derive the maximum speed for mainline curves. Mainline traction speed time curve. you have to analyze this properly, whether it is a trapezoidal or main line, both are same. Okay, now let us draw the curve. So speed will be measured in kilometer per hour and time will be measured in minutes or seconds. So in this case we will perform the analysis by taking the seconds. So let us assume some of the components. Let alpha, beta, Vm, S are the components we are considering for the analysis, and we have one more T. Okay, so alpha is considered as acceleration, in kilometer per hour per second, and this is retardation, again in kmph per second. Then I have maximum speed, or I can say crest speed, then we have total distance. Between the destinations, and T will be total time required. Total time, let us define it as a total time. So these are the time of run. So I will just mention total time of run. Total time of run. So for this, I will take this in second. Total distance in, I will take it as kilometer. So these are the components required for performing the carrying out the analysis. So therefore, just check it. Now we know that the time required for the acceleration, that is 0 to T1. Time required for the acceleration 0 to T1 means I can say that time required for acceleration is T1. So how to find it? The maximum speed reached will be Vm. Okay. So maximum speed divided by the acceleration period, or the acceleration, the amount of acceleration applied. So T is equal to Vm divided by alpha. We know that acceleration into time will give us maximum speed. Okay, that is speed. Speed is equal to acceleration into time. So this is time of acceleration T1. Similarly, time of deceleration will be Vm divided by beta. That means from Vm it is reaching to this. So time of retardation we can say that as T3, and then the time of time for free run, we can find it by taking T2 is equal to what? Total time minus sum of T1 and T3, that is equal to T minus Vm by alpha plus Vm by beta. Okay, so that is my T2. So I have the time required for acceleration will be Vm by alpha, retardation Vm by beta, and T2 is equal to total time minus acceleration and retardation time. So T minus Vm by alpha plus Vm by beta. These are the component of time. Now let us find the total distance covered can be determined by determining the area covered by the trapezoidal curve. So therefore, the total distance of run in kilometer, that is S, will be equal to distance traveled during the acceleration, then distance traveled during the free run, and distance traveled during the braking. So the amount of distance traveled can be determined by considering the amount of area covered by the curve. So therefore, the total distance covered S is equal to half of maximum speed multiplied by amount of time required T1 by 3600. Similarly, the total distance covered during the free time run can be measured by taking it is a rectangular that is equal to length into breadth. And this is equal to again half Vm T3 by 3600. Okay. So that is equal to, let's take it, Vm, what is T1 is Vm by alpha. So I will substitute here Vm divided by 7200 times alpha. What I have done? I have substituted T1 value, Vm by alpha here. Okay, plus Vm, what is T2 is equal to T minus T1 plus T3 divided by 3600. Okay, so we'll substitute afterward. Plus here it is again Vm, T3 is equal to Vm again. So it is Vm into Vm becomes Vm square, or I write it one more step, Vm into Vm divided by, this is equal to 7200 times beta. Okay, now let us rearrange and check it. That is equal to Vm square 7200 alpha plus Vm T by 3600 minus Vm, T1 is equal to Vm by alpha. So Vm square divided by 3600 into alpha. Am I right? Vm in 1 Vm and T1 becomes Vm by alpha. So another Vm. So Vm square dividing by 3006 times alpha. I have written directly. Similarly, this also equal to Vm square 3600 times beta. Am I right? And then plus Vm square 7200 times beta will be the derivation. That is equal to, I will write this first, Vm T divided by 3600. Now just take it. Now what I will do is, for better analysis, I will make it multiply 2 in the both numerator and denominator. So 2 times Vm square dividing by 7200. So 2 times minus 2 times plus 1 time becomes equal to minus 1 time. So I will write it that as Vm square divided by 7200 alpha. Am I right? Similarly, I will produce it for this Vm square divided by 7200 times beta. I have just modified. Okay, that is equal to S here. right? I'll just erase this. Now just check it. I will try to rearrange the terms. I will take Vm square dividing by 3600 outside, and I will just rearrange the equation. So I will take Vm square divided by 3600 outside. So remaining in the bracket, I will put it. What is remaining here? Vm square 3600 gone. 1 dividing by 2 times alpha. So I will make it 1 divided by 2 times alpha plus 1 divided by 2 times beta will come. Am I right? So I have taken this entirely on the another side. So both becomes positive. So therefore Vm square divided by 3600 square alpha minus this term I will write it. Vm t divided by 3600 plus s is equal to 0 I will write. I hope I'm very much clear here. Right? So I have taken Vm 3600 outside, 1 dividing by 2 alpha, 1 dividing by 2 beta. Both I have taken another side becomes positive. This I have taken another side becomes negative. Okay. So what I have done, by taking this, I have formed one quadratic equation. Now, let us consider constant k, which is equal to 1 dividing by 2 alpha plus 1 divided by 2 beta. I will consider this as a constant. So therefore, this is equal to Vm square divided by 3600 k minus Vm t divided by 3600 plus s is equal to 0. Therefore, k times Vm square minus Vm t plus 3600 s is equal to 0 will be our quadratic equation. Now, this is a quadratic equation. So, to find the value of Vm, that is the maximum speed or crest speed, I have to just take the roots of the equation. So I will take the roots of the equation. Roots of the equation can be find. Vm is equal to b times. So what is the value of b is? Roots of Vm I am finding. So b is equal to t b plus or minus square root of b square, that is t square, minus what? A into c. B square minus 4ac. 4 into k into 3600. Okay. S divide by 2 times A. So value of A is K. This is the roots of the quadratic equation. Therefore, Vm is equal to T plus or minus square root of T square minus 3600 into 4. 7200, double of that. 7000 double is 14000, 200 double is 400. K into S divided by 2 times K. So this gives us the maximum speed or crest speed possible for the trapezoidal curve or mainline systems, okay, which we can determine. Now, the positive sign cannot be adopted due to the reason that as the value of Vm obtained by using positive sign will be much higher. If I take the positive sign in this quadratic equation here, this positive, the value of Vm will be much higher value, which will result into the radius of schedule time. So therefore, it will not be considered. So much higher than possible practices. Therefore, negative sign can be used. And by taking the negative sign, we can just evaluate the value of crest speed. So by taking a negative sign, we are just determining the crest speed, which is equal to, just take it, I will just write here, discard positive sign, positive value, because what? The Vm will be due to very high Vm value. This results into very high Vm value, so we are discarding this. That is some key note. You should remember this. So by knowing that, with negative sign, that is equal to T divided by 2K minus square root of T square dividing by 4K square minus. Now again 4 gets cancelled, so that is equal to 3600 remaining. 1K gets cancelled, 3600 this divided by K. This is the value of Vm for trapezoidal curve. Okay, so value of Vm for trapezoidal curve can be determined by considering only negative sign of the roots for the quadratic equation here, that is for Vm. So that is equal to T dividing by 2 times K minus of T square by 4 K square plus minus of 3600 S by K. Okay, so remember this formula. We have the numericals on this. Probably we will take it in the next class. We have just terminated the time. So with this, we will just stop for today. In the next class, I will have numerical on this, and we will try to cover the quadrilateral curve, speed time curve derivation for the crest speed or maximum speed. Okay. So remember this formula: Vm is equal to T divided by 2K minus T square 4K square minus 3600 S by K. Remember, we are discarding the positive sign because that results into very high Vm value, which is in practice actually not possible to consider. So do not forget to download the notes before you go through the video. See you in the next class.